Today on BRStv, we have our 18th episode of the Neptune Apex series with ramp profiles and Kessil lighting. Hi, I'm Ryan, host of BRStv, where each week we cover a new topic related to reefing. This week we're going to show you how to use the ramp option within profile section of the Apex Fusion interface. This is most commonly used to control LED lighting, which has a variable voltage output, which lets you dim or color shift your LEDs. Since I have some Kessil LEDs on my personal office tank, we're going to use these to show you how to use variable voltage and user profiles to control them. The Kessils have two channels, one for light intensity and one for color. The single cord can handle both channels, signified by the V1 and V2 on the variable voltage port we're going to plug the cord into. The first step is to hit the Profiles tab in Fusion, select an unused profile, and change the type to ramp. Since we're going to effectively ramp the lights up and down for dawn and dusk effects, we have to create two profiles for this. I'm going to name the first one KessilDawn. There are three fields we need to fill out. It's pretty common to leave the start intensity at 0 and the end at 100, which means at the start of the day the lights will be at 0% power and slowly ramp up to 100%. The ramp time is just how long it'll take to do this. In this case, I'd like to do it over the course of 2 hours, so I'll enter 120 minutes and send to Apex. Next, I need to create a profile for what I want the light to do at dusk, which is basically the same thing in reverse. Name it KessilDusk, select ramp as a profile type. In this case, I want to ramp down for dusk, so I'll start with 100% and end with 0% intensity. I want to have the same ramp time, so I'll enter 120 minutes again and send to Apex. Okay, so that was all about the power or intensity of the lighting. Since we have a second channel, we're also going to change the color at dawn and dusk as well. Make another profile. I'm going to call this one KDawn Color and select ramp as a profile type again. This time we're ramping the color. If you turn the knob on the top of the Kessil lighting, you can see it slowly turns bluer. This is an effect we're going to ramp up and down for dusk and dawn. Zero is as blue as the light gets. In this case, I'm going to start there and my end intensity will be 90%, which is almost all the way white, but not quite. And the color I like for daylight. In this case, I'm going to do a ramp time of 180 minutes because I like to see the tank bluer longer. And I can compensate for the lack of intensity with a longer photo period. By now you're probably catching on to this, and we're going to create one last profile with the name KDusk Color, profile type ramp, ramp time 180 minutes. This time the color is going to be in reverse, and I'll start with 90%, which is the daylight spectrum, and ramp down to zero for the end intensity. Okay, so we have four profiles created. We have a couple of additional steps. First, we need to tie our new profiles to the variable speed outlets. If you inserted your cord into the V1, V2 outlet, then locate the variable voltage outlet labeled VARSPEED 2 and click the settings gear next to it. I'm going to name the outlet Kessil Power, select Advanced, and type in the following three lines of code. Set off. I want the lights to turn on at 9 a.m., so I'll enter if time 0900 to 1600, then Kessil Dawn, which is the name of our dawn light intensity profile. Capitalization and spaces are important. 1600 is when I want to start my dusk effect, which is 2 hours long, so the next line is time 1600 to 1800, then Kessil Dusk, which is the dusk profile. So we're almost home. Locate VARSPEED 1, rename it Kessil Color, hit Advanced Control Type, then enter if time 0900 to 1500, then KDawn Color. Since we have a 3 hour ramp time on the color, this will start the profile 1 hour earlier than the intensity profile with if time 1500 to 1800, then KDusk Color. Set both to auto and you're done. The Kessil's power cord can be plugged into the wall, but if you'd like additional controls, you can plug them into an outlet on the energy bar. In this case, selecting control type light, fall back off, which will turn the lights off if the Apex base unit were to ever get disconnected from the energy bar for some reason, enter the on time of 0900 and 1800, shut down probe temp, and the temp at which you want the controller to turn the lights off if the tank were overheating for some reason. I would leave the hysteresis at 30 minutes, which means the lights will stay off for a full 30 minutes before they turn back on. On a final note, by the time you've seen this, Neptune may have already implemented a new interface for the Kessil lights in Fusion, which makes this process much easier. I know it's in the works right now. However, what we did today can be used on any Apex-ready light that uses a variable voltage port to dim the lights. If you have any questions about the apex ramp profiles or any solid tips for your fellow reefers, check out the comments area down below. If this is your first time with us, hit that subscribe button because we do this every week. See you next week with another episode of BRStv.